Hello, Pewter people. Scott Reynolds here with another Pewter Pulse. Each year, there is a Buccaneer player or two that receives a lot of off-season hype by the media heading into training camp. Sometimes that hype is amplified early in camp before the pads come on. And ultimately, some of that hype turns out to be unwarranted, as some of the players that Pewter Report and other media outlets report on just don't live up to the hype. They turn out to be busts instead. Who are some of the more overhyped Bucs from the past? And more importantly, who are some of this year's players who are receiving some hype heading into training camp and may not live up to it? Well, I've been covering this team for 29 years now, and my memory only goes back so far. But one of the first overhyped Bucs I remember was defensive end Patrick Chukwuorah, who signed a five-year, $5.5 million contract to play for John Gruden and the Buccaneers in 2007. You don't remember Chukwuorah? Come on, the 6'1", 250-pound, muscle-bound Chukwuorah dazzled in OTAs with his speed, whipping by offensive linemen who weren't really allowed to block him. Chukwuorah came from Denver and had been in the league 6 years, where he had notched a total of 8 sacks, including a career-high 4.5 sacks with the Broncos in 2006 that piqued the Bucs' interest. But this guy was not the first coming of Shaq Barrett. Far from it. Once the pads came on in camp in the preseason, Chukwuorah and his chiseled physique did not live up to the hype, as he got out-muscled and only played in just 9 games in Tampa Bay and finished with 11 tackles and 1 sack. He was released prior to the 2008 season after just 1 year, and he signed a 5-year deal too. Well, you know, the Bucs have had plenty of free agent busts over the years, right? Guys like Chukwuorah, as well as running back Derek Ward in 2009, cornerback Eric Wright in 2012, left tackle Anthony Collins and defensive end Michael Johnson in 2014, defensive tackle Chris Baker, I believe that was in 2017, among other guys that failed to live up to their hype and some of those massive contracts in some of those cases that they arrived in free agency. But let's focus on some of the overhyped rookies that never really amounted to much. You know, one of the names that I think Buccaneer fans will remember is Kenny Bell, wide receiver, 5th-round pick in 2015. The 6-foot, 197-pound Bell blazed a 4.38 at the combine and was Nebraska's career receiving yards leader. He was the star of the rookie minicamp as Jameis Winston's primary target, and he got open and made dazzling catches in OTAs and at the start of training camp. Then the preseason began, and the pads came on, and Bell fumbled the opening kickoff at Philadelphia in the preseason opener, and it all unraveled for him. Bell had more drops than catches in the preseason. He had 0 catches, as a matter of fact, before the team stashed him on injured reserve with a hamstring injury. They just tried to give him some time, but Bell never made the progress behind the scenes in the 2016 preseason as he shied away from contact and never felt comfortable under the lights. He was released after a lot of hype in just 1 season in Tampa Bay. Another guy with a similar story, you might remember Jalen Darden, a 4th-round pick in 2021. He received similar hype to Bell as he was just about uncoverable. Is that a word? In OTA practices. But when the pads came on in the second week of training camp, Darden, like Bell, wilted, shied away from contact, especially over the middle. His lack of intestinal fortitude also showed up on punt and kick returns, where he often went to the ground before contact or made a beeline right for the sidelines to get out of bounds to avoid being hit. Now, we in the media got fooled not once, but twice by the Darden hype, first during his rookie season and then again heading into the 2022 training camp when everyone in the building thought he was one of the more improved players. After all, that's what the Bucs coaches, players, and personnel people were telling us at the time. Darden spent 2 seasons with the Bucs catching just 8 passes for 69 yards, and he underwhelmed as a return specialist. Moving on to Sean Tucker, the running back who was last year's overhyped Buccaneer. Now, Tucker missed the entire offseason due to a heart ailment. The team felt it got a steal in this undrafted free agent as he brought sub-4.4 speed to the backfield. Tucker won the number two running back job in camp behind Rashad White, but then fizzled out with just 23 yards on 15 carries at the start of the season. That's a woeful 1.5 yard average. Yikes. And that's why he didn't see much playing time down the stretch. Now, with the drafting of Bucky Irving this year, Tucker is not a lock to make the team, especially with Chase Edmonds at that running back three spot. And if Tucker does make the team, it will likely be as a fourth string running back. Servassier Dennis, fifth round pick, linebacker out of Pitt, was also on the hype train last summer as he recorded four pick sixes in practice. One of those came in the rookie minicamp, then two happened in OTAs, and then another one came about in training camp. But when the lights came on in the preseason, Dennis didn't shine in the exhibition opener against Pittsburgh, and then he missed the rest of the preseason with a hamstring injury, so his hype kind of fizzled. Now, not every training camp sleeper gets overhyped, though. Some players actually live up to the hype. And that's a good thing for the Bucs and Bucs fans, right? So that was the case last year with a couple of players, nickel cornerback Christian Isian and outside linebacker Marquise Watts. Both of those guys were undrafted free agents. Isian beat out sixth-round pick Josh Hayes for the slot cornerback role, started every game last year as a rookie. Watts made the team last year as an undrafted free agent out of Charlotte, and he actually beat out six-round draft pick Jose Ramirez, who wound up on the practice squad. And Watts finished the year with a 23% pass rush win rate and also had a sack. That pass rush win rate was the highest on the team. Watts is getting a lot of hype again this season heading into the training camp, and he could rise up the depth chart if he turns his buzz into production this summer, and especially in those preseason games. Now, Ramirez is also getting a lot of hype, so keep an eye on him as well. But there's another name out there, and that's wide receiver Cameron Johnson, a very athletic receiver from Tiny Barton College. He could also factor into Tampa Bay's kick and punt return competitions this year. So Ramirez, Johnson, and also Trey Palmer, second-year wide receiver. Those are some buzzworthy names heading into training camp. We'll see if they live up to the hype or if they'll become the latest names that team sources whisper in our ears that turn out to be overhyped in the end. Well, one thing that's not a lot of hype is the fact that we've got some great video content at Pewter Report TV. That's our YouTube channel. That's where you can find my Pewter Pulse episodes, as well as other great Bucs video content, such as the Pewter Report podcast. What we want you to do is hit the like button. Please do that and subscribe to Pewter Report TV. When you hit the like button, and also leave a comment, do those two things. It helps our algorithm, helps us get in front of more pewter people like you on YouTube. We appreciate that. Also, follow us on X, Facebook, and Instagram at Pewter Report. And also, pewterreport.com, where we'll have all sorts of Bucs content available all the way until training camp. And I'll be back soon with another Pewter Pulse.